So my name is Peter Biara Jack. I'm the director for the Center for Strategic Analysis and Research. I'm also the deputy country director for the International Growth Center, which is another think tank based at Oxford University and the London School of Economics. And that one is largely engaged in economic research, especially in the areas of economic growth. So these are the main things that I do here in South Sudan. We collect a lot of information, we do research to provide advice on policy. Now, in the past, it has largely been the government that demand a lot of this, but we could theoretically do this sort of research and analysis for private companies and actors.
And that, I expect, will be the growing market for you.
I hope so. The challenges of South Sudan are quite extreme. As you very well know, literacy rate is very high, work experience is very limited, and things like data and statistics are also very new here and have never been used. And the legacy of war coming back from a situation in which decisions were made on feeling or hunches and based on what today presents, you don't have an entrenched culture of looking at data or necessarily needing it. We are helping change the way people think and way people make decisions by telling them that information is extremely relevant, and they're already beginning to see it, especially with the macroeconomic situation in the country is in today. We've been arguing for a very long time you need to diversify the economy, yet with the challenges in the economic growth, but nobody was listening. But I think now with this kind of crisis, people are beginning to pay attention to the data and what does the data actually say. The African countries were always better off than South Sudan. And this is, up to now, we are still a pre-market agrarian society with very limited interactions of civilians. The only period in which we had increased interaction were during the war, in which people were displaced from wherever they were, from their villages, they come and mingle. But it was a situation that was not necessarily encouraging for market, because people were met not necessarily to exchange ideas or to exchange products, but people were running away to save their lives. So it was a different sort of environment. Now, other African countries, because some of them are now in their fifth decade of statehood, they have had a lot of time to go through a transition period in which I think now they have a relatively well-established appreciation of data and information, which is not the case for South Sudan. So we are establishing a state in the 21st century when we are not really adapted to the 21st century mechanisms on how a state actually operates. Research have shown that pure laissez-faire is not practical anywhere in the world. The role of the government to create conducive environment for private sector growth is extremely relevant. And for the government to do that, it requires the government capabilities. So the first question that a country like South Sudan faces, how do you build state capabilities? What we need to do and what we should do is to look at what capacity do we have, and then what problems do we have, and we take like the 21st century technology or advancement in institutional development, and we make it adaptable to our existing capabilities, and we use it to solve the problem that we have. So my argument would be, let's not copy the land law that they have in Germany or in Kenya, but let's see like what are the practices of what people use. Let's find a way in which we use the existing practices and the capacity we have to solve the problem of land, for example. And if we succeed in solving that, we'd keep doing that. And the more we do it, it become a practice that would become an institution by itself. Certainly, as I mentioned before, capacity is a serious problem here in the country. Not necessarily just in the government, but also everywhere else in the private sector. You would even argue that the best minds are already in the government that are not being used properly. So now when you look in the private sector or the media agency, they're extremely limited in terms of capabilities. At the same time, too, they don't know exactly what they may be looking for. As we learned this morning, a lot of radios and newspapers are dependent largely or even completely on advertisement. But they don't really know why the advertisers that are using the medium, why are they selecting them and not the other people? they have not asked those kind of questions. At the same time, too, they don't know why their listeners or those who actually read their newspapers, why do they select that particular newspaper instead of the other one? So these questions have not been established. And I think it goes back to the whole argument about information. And you need information to make decisions, whether in the government, in the private sector, whether in your own house. You need information. And what these guys lack is information.